On December 7th of 1941, the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor. Upon hearing of this on January 13th of 1942, after being denied admittance to the Navy because of his colorblindness, Walter Moretti, a 21-year-old from Boston, Massachusetts, joined the Coast Guard as a last resort attempt at helping his country. He tells this story of his joining.
I went down to Gallup's Island for a week, and they needed somebody that could type, and I hadn't typed for a few years. And so I was in the office where they were signing up people to join the Coast Guard, and an officer came in and was looking for somebody that could type. And so I happened to be there, and he gave me a piece of paper and put it in a typewriter, and I took off. And so he made arrangements that I'd be sent back to the Coast Guard office in the Custom House in Boston.
After his training in Boston, he was let off at an office where he met his future wife, Gertrude McIntosh.
I never knew Nana before. We were in the Coast Guard. And that's how, after I come off the first ship, which was a year and a half after I first joined, I met her in the office where I got transferred off the ship to, and that's where I went out with her on a, let's see, it was New Year's Eve, and it was 1943, 1944, when we met after I got off the first ship, and then we knew each other for about 4 months, and we got married, and then after she got married, and
About 5 months after their wedding, Gertrude received an honorable discharge from the spars because she was pregnant. Very soon after this, Walter was deployed on a ship to Iceland. This ship was a member of a convoy used to protect merchant and supply ships. He worked as a bookkeeper on this ship. In March of 1943, Walter Moretti participated in the largest convoy battle in World War II, the Battle of the Atlantic. Fortunately, Walter left the battle with no scars, just memories. Walter then left HX229 for another convoy ship, SC121, where he was an assistant. He tells a story of when he came across a boat that had been torpedoed.
Jesus, it's a horrible sight to see bodies just floating by his ship. They're all dead.
Oh my God, tell me this won't last forever. Tell me that I'm not alone. Tell me this will come together now.
He also spent time in the Pacific and comments that the food was lousy and he lost a lot of weight. While there, he explains that his greatest moment was fighting at Okinawa. The Japanese fought hard, but eventually the U.S. won. Walter returned home, but his time in the active duty Coast Guard never left him. Since the war, Walter has received the Atlantic Service Medal and the Russian Commemorative Medal. He and his shipmates formed a meeting or support group upon returning, which lasted until recently when the members became too old to maintain it. When asked his final thoughts on the war, Walter comments,
"It's a horrible thing. I'll never forget it."
So.